Hi guys, quick and last update about my new studio, because I almost finished all the main jobs and all the main works here. We just have some kind of really small touches everywhere, but even the corner of the bass drop is also done. So everything is connected, all the synths are working, all the groove boxes, the DJ gear, all the outboard effects, everything is connected already to the mixer. Yeah, you see, the BML Christmas tree is gone. So, yeah, it's finished. What I still left is to play a bit with the Coppel and MIDI system, because of course they forgot everything, all the settings. I still have a bit of work on a mixer, because I wanna create a new kind of settings, let's say profiles, for different kind of recording scenarios, like only outboard mixing from the box, recording to the computer, or mastering, or analog summing, whatever. So I created a lot of new cable set for that, and now I'm quite happy with this new setup. Ah, and I get a new baby here, which is the TC Electronic Fireworks, this one here. Guys, this is some kind of really interesting, really weird kind of effect, so I'm sure I will do a video on that. All the rest, everything is okay, everything is working fine, even the DJ gear, the speaker system. I also bought a new camera for the live events. It's some kind of Sony AX3000 small camera, but really great stuff. I just have this cable over there. I don't know what is this for, so nobody remember for it what is this for, but I think this is one line of the lamp or whatever, so this will be fixed. And I have a few small problems with the synths. Maybe because they also sleep for 1 year, for example, the virus has some problem with the aftertouch, it's not sensitive enough. So I think maybe some kind of moisture issue, or maybe some kind of small animal is living inside in the aftertouch sensor. The Novation get a really weird kind of error on the digital to analog converter. But I find on some forums it's really common, so I already ordered for that new converters. And the GX10 from the Roland, it has some kind of noise. I don't know what kind of noise, but I think this kind of noises came from the power source, so mainly some capacitor or something is dried out. But all the rest is okay. And now I just start to deal with the monitoring system, because I want these old Hungarian hi-fi speakers to involve into my mixing, because I really know well this speaker. This is the only speaker in the past in Hungary that we can order and what we can use. So almost every household have a pair from that, and wherever we went when we as kids, we always listen to this speaker. So, and it's actually quite good, not quite good, is freaking good, this speaker. It's kind of linear, but it's really sophisticated on the details. I don't know how the Hungarians did that in the 70s. Actually, this one from 81 or 79, I don't remember, a sticker on the back, so maybe I will do a video on that. But I'm telling you guys, I want this speaker on my monitoring session. And I also want to replace my small Yamaha monitor speaker, because now in this new room and with this lot of space and lot of air, these speakers are really small. So I will move them to here, just give some kind of monitoring to the synths. Maybe I will buy from that other pair. So I will install one set to here and I will install one set to here. I don't know, or maybe I just will install them behind the scenes. So the reason for that change is when I'm playing here with the synthesizers, I always have to listen to the monitors, which is, you know, it's only on the left side if I'm staying there. So I want some kind of speaker solution here. And this guy, my tape recorder, it's because this is also seated in my basement for almost 1 year. So all the calibration is gone. And I don't know where is my calibration tape, so it's take from me 4 days to fix it. And unfortunately, I don't know where is the original calibration paper that I get from the Tascam. They're really nice guys. They send it to me by email, but I couldn't find it. And what I find is only Japanese. So you can imagine how I repaired this tape machine, but no, everything is good, everything is fine. And I'm quite happy with the results. So now the DBX processor inside is it's working perfectly. I already tried it with some kind of really bubblegum music, but no, it's fixed. So, and the rest of the studio is also done. I just have here a couple of stuffs what I have to sort out, and maybe some gears we came to the big giveaway. And here we just have to install the projector system. I think I will install back this Epson Full HD 3LCD projector because I really like the color of the human skin tone on that because of the 3LCD technology. So definitely I will install back just to watch old kind of movies, but of course the new projector will come. And here in a lab, everything is connected, everything is working. I also installed to the window the shutter system, and it's almost done. Here I just have a few things what I have to sort out and hide in my storage box on the top. And that's it. We are done, mostly. Just really small touches what is left, guys. So from the next week, I will start a new age of the BML Studio. And I will upload more frequently videos, not about the studio construction, but about a lot of interesting and new stuffs. And guys, just stay tuned and see you next time.